गुड मॉर्निंग सर, दिस इज भार्गवी मोरटकी फ्रॉम के डिवीजन एंड माय रोल नंबर इज 1127 एंड वी आर टीम 11. द प्रोजेक्ट इज वर्टिकल ड्राइंग बोर्ड एंड द टीम मेंबर्स आर समर्थ 1102, सुप्रिया 1111, विनायक 1148, प्रशांत 1153. नाउ लेट्स मूव टू द प्रॉब्लम डेफिनेशन ऑफ आवर कोर्स प्रोजेक्ट. डिजाइन अ सेमी ऑटोमेटिक ड्राइंग बोर्ड which can draw on wall, which can draw various designs, which is also portable. The cost of the machine should be less than Rs. 4000. Weight of the machine should be less than 4 kgs. Size of the machine should be 2.5 into 2.5 into 1 feet. It should draw designs of size less than 1.5 into 1.5 feet. It should have pen holder that can hold pen size of 5 mm to 15 mm. It should run for 3 hours. It should navigate through XY axis. It should interface with the user through software installed on the computing device. It should have an adjustable pen holder. It should promote the users before starting the drawing process. It should be able to stand firmly and independently on the drawing surface. Machine should give a real-time depiction of drawing process. Machine should indicate completion of the drawing process.
And the next slide is about function tree and functional clustering. So for our project, we have made four major units. They are processing unit, motion control unit, indication unit, and structural unit. And again, in processing unit, we have divided the functions into two. They are input unit and interface unit. And in motion control unit, there are again three sub functions. They are abscissa movement, ordinate movement, and pen lifting movement. And in indication unit, there are again two sub functions. There are on and off indicator and completion indicator. And again in structural unit, there is one more function, that is frame. Here are the main subsystems identified. Those are processing unit, motion control unit, indication unit, and structural unit. And this slide is about the generated concept. And the concept one is mainly about the red shaft drawing board. It mainly consists of buzzer, battery, Arduino board, wooden frame, stepper motor, pencil, mini piston attached to screw type holder. And this mainly works through red shaft.
Concept 2. Here we have used display wall, pressure pipe, piston, Arduino board, hydraulic pump, LED, CNC, and we have a side view of gondola here where it is consist of screw type holder and a mini piston.
Next concept is concept 3. In this concept, we have used belt for power transmission, a screw type pen holder, and laptop as an interface device.
Concept 4. This concept consists of steel frame guide rails, Arduino board, CNC controller, and screw type pen holder. Steel frame holds the entire system. Guide rails used for movement in X and Y axis. Arduino and CNC controller used for automation purpose, and buzzer is used for indication unit.
Concept 5. This consists of wooden frame, Arduino board, servo motor, cables, LED, and screw type marker holder. Servo motor is used for the movement of marker.
Next, we move on to virtual implementation. This is the 3D model of our entire system. This is the front view. This is the side view. This is the back view. This is the close-up view of the gondola. Gondola is the pen holding unit. It is hung by two belts. The servo motor is attached to the gondola. The servo motor is the linear actuator here. It controls the pen lifting operation. This is a adjustable pen holder. It can hold pen of various sizes. This is a motor pulley. Motor pulley connects the belt and the motor and transfers the power to the belt. The belt is wrapped around the pulley. The grooves in the belt and the pulley mesh up and transform for a smooth movement and precise movement. This is the stepper motor. This is the actuator for moving the gondola. Stepper motors are held by motor clamp. The motor clamp in turn are held by elbow joints. Elbow joints join the vertical frame and the horizontal frame together. This is a weight. Weights help to keep tension in the belt. Tension is required for precision movement. This is a foot. Foot help this machine to stand firmly and independently of the drawing surface. This entire plane surface is the drawing surface on which the gondola moves and draws the design or the diagrams given to it. The frame, elbow joint, foot, sheet and the motor clamp all form the structural unit. The gondola forms the pen holding unit and the servo motor and the stepper motor form the motion control unit. Next, we move on to circuit diagram of the entire system. We have used a CNC shield which is capped on Arduino Uno R3 and it is supplied with 5 volt DC. And the stepper motor, servo motor and the indication unit are attached to the CNC shield itself. Next, we move on to bill of materials required for the entire system. We have used various parts. These are microcontroller, Arduino Uno, shield, CNC shield, servo motor, stepper motor driver, GT2 pulley, GT2 rubber belt, LED, weights, power adapter, foot, elbow, gondola, clamps, and structural frame.
So now, let's move on to the flowchart model of entire system. Let's begin. We will input regular diagram to polar plot software. Then that regular diagram will be proceeded and converted into vector diagram to Arduino. If processing becomes unsuccessful, it will ask the input again for the regular diagram. There are three main divisions in this process. The first step is left servo motor starts working for designing for the diagram given. When diagram is completed, LED will glow immediately. Let's go to the servo motor working. Here, if the pen is lifted, pen will go up and servo motor starts working. Suppose if it is not lifted, it will be still in the process. Once the processing is done, the LED will start glowing. Right stepper motor. Here, it is as same as the left stepper motor working. If the diagram is completed, LED will start glowing. Hence, the processing is done.
Next, we move on to motor sizing and battery sizing of the entire system. We have used two actuators, stepper motor and servo motor. Servo motor needs a torque of 0.21 kg/cm and stepper motor needs a torque of 0.165 kg/cm. We have chosen 28 BYG48 stepper motor and SG90 servo motor. We need a backup for 3 hours, hence battery size of 2.7 Ah is required.
Functional specifications of the entire system. These are draw various designs, machine should indicate on and off status, navigate through X and Y axis, interface with the user through the software installed on the computing device, should have adjustable pen holder, prompt the users before starting the drawing process, should be able to stand firmly and independently of the drawing surface, machine should give real-time depiction of the drawing process, machine should indicate completion of drawing process.
Next, we move on to modeling and simulation. This is the Tinkercad simulation of our machine. In this simulation, we have an Arduino Uno R3 and servo motor, two stepper motors and an indication LED and depictive LEDs for the stepper motor coils pinned on a breadboard. When we start the simulation, the indication LED glows green and the stepper motor start rotating. These indicate the coil order of the stepper motors. And the servo motor turns 0 to 90 and then back to 90. The indication LED glows red, indicating the end of process. This LED glows again green for the new process. This process goes on until the drawing is complete. Next, we move on to physical implementation. This is our polar plot software used for interfacing with the machine. This software also enables for inputting image and real-time depiction of the drawing process. Next, we move on to circuit implementation in real life. This is the CNC shield capped on Arduino with all the wirings. This is the indication LED on off, servo motor, our two stepper motors. Moving on to the complete physical implementation of the machine. Here the machine is complete and the gondola is drawing the diagram. We have inputted the diagram with the laptop. Here it's showing the real-time depiction.